Good morning. Okay, we're gonna try that again. I know, it's Sunday morning. Here we go, you ready? One, two, three. Good morning.
Good morning.
See, I knew you were there. It is good to be here in worship on a beautiful day. For those of you who do not know me, my name is Reverend Jessica Brendler Naulty, and it is a gift to be here with you on this glorious day. Welcome to the Clinton United Methodist Church. For you who were here gathered in person, we're so glad you're here. For those who are gathered worshiping online, we are so glad that you are here with us as well. We're going to take a moment to pass the peace of Christ, which means to greet one another with words of peace. You can say, peace be with you. You can say, peace. If you're greeting from far away, you may do a peace sign if you're kind of keeping COVID distance. You can bow. And that's, it's actually a respect of some of our interreligious traditions, because when you bow and you say namaste, you are saying the God in me sees the God in you. So you don't have to say namaste, but you're welcome to if you want to, and just bow and look one another in the eye and greet each other with the peace and love of Christ. Let us rise and greet one another now. So for many of you who know Sandy, she's on vacation this weekend, and Beth and I just went, oh, there's no lights. How are we doing temperature-wise? Do we need some air conditioning, or are you comfortable? It's a little warm, or maybe we can't turn the fan on because they have not been cleaned in a little while. They're pretty high. In a little while. So I'm going to move us into our opening prayer today, so I invite you to join your heart and spirit with mine in prayer. Generous God, giver of all good gifts, gifts of life, love, and relationships, gifts of work and leisure, effort and rest, and most of all, your gift of salvation through Christ's love and your Spirit's presence and power. By your love and strength, you work all things together for good. Move through us now in this time of worship that we might grow closer to you, learn more about how you call us to use the gifts you bless us with, and serve our neighbors in love. Open our ears to hear, our hearts to love, and our hands to serve. Amen. 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 I invite you to rise in body or in spirit as we sing our opening hymn, What Gift Can We Bring, number 87. Let's rise and sing together.
Thank you. Good morning. To all you hot or cold people, you can kind of give me evil looks if it is getting too hot or cold in here. We'll fix it for you. I'm a terrible arbiter of temperature, so sorry. Hi to our people online. Thank you for worshiping with us. Good to see you this morning. It's Happy Encanto Sunday. I'm hoping that some of you who are here in person can join us afterwards and watch Encanto with us. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Beth Crawford, and I'm on staff here at Clinton UMC. We've got a lot of good things going on, and it's my pleasure to share a few of them with you today. First of all, college students and their parents. If you would like an angel from Clinton UMC to keep in touch with you while you're away and send you notes and pray for you and, I don't know, maybe send a treat from time to time, contact the church office. And I think there may or may not be sign-up sheets available, but definitely you can get in touch with Sandy. We have plenty of angels because y'all have been so generous in responding. So we are just looking for young adults to send gifts to. All right, and in fact, I know today we're going to be talking about gifts. So we're going to talk about a couple of ways that you can share your gifts to build up the community that is Clinton UMC. If you are gifted in or interested in audio and visual and communications and the things that our awesome digital ministry team does, there will be a training next Sunday right after the service. If I can do it, you can do it. Trust me on that one. You can talk to Eric or Erica or anybody who's on the team, or you can contact the church office. We can answer your questions. It would be great if we know to expect you, but there's no RSVP required. If your gifts include eating snacks, laughing, playing cards, I understand you don't even have to be that gifted at playing cards. Join us Saturday, October 8th for Crazy Card Night. It's a fun night of community that's sponsored by the CARE Committee. You can see Priscilla Cartwright for more details, and Priscilla's right over there, or contact the church office. All right, let's turn to Bible studies. It's almost time for the Faithful and Inclusive Bible Study to start. We know from our earlier survey that our church family has a lot of, a wide variety of views on this subject, so it's something we will continue to keep talking about. And we really want to provide a safe space where people can talk about the scripture, interpretations, and navigating our differences with a lot of love and grace and listening. So please join us. There are online versions and in-person versions, and Tuesday mornings here at Clinton UMC, and Wednesday evenings are on Zoom, and you can get more information from the church office, and I believe there's something in your bulletin today as well. That's our announcements for this morning. Thank you for listening, and now I think it's time for our children's time.
Not yet.
I would like to now invite our baptism family forward. We have the honor and privilege of sharing in the baptism of Colin Patrick Ritchie. In your bulletin, you will find an insert that goes along with our service. It'll be up on the screen for the congregational responses, but you're welcome to follow along with all of those pieces there. And there are some responses for y'all, but it's okay. I will absolutely lead you in with that. So no worries, no stress. Beloved of God, the sacrament of baptism symbolizes the love of God, which reaches out to us even when we are very young. We are here today to declare that God loves Colin Patrick Ritchie and to offer ourselves as the instruments of that love in his life. Through the sacrament of baptism, God's Spirit initiates us into Christ's holy church, invites us into a covenantal relationship, reminds us of God's love offered for all and gives us new birth through water and the Spirit. So come to the water, water poured over and immersing us, water flowing freely for all, water that brings hope, nurtures growth, and offers new birth. Here we come to the waters to baptize Colin and to remember our own baptisms. In each other's presence, we renew our commitments to Christ who has raised us, the Spirit who has birthed us, and the Creator who is making all things new. I invite you now to present Colin. Could you read that together?
We present Colin Patrick Ritchie for baptism.
Thank you. As you present Colin for holy baptism, do you affirm your faith in Jesus as Christ, your Redeemer, Savior, and friend? Put your whole trust in his grace and promise to live a life of service in partnership with the church which Christ has opened to all people. If so, say, we do. Do you repent of your sin and commit to choosing love in action, turning away from evil and hate? If so, say, we do.
We do.
Right. Do you accept the freedom and power God gives you to resist evil, injustice, and oppression in whatever forms they present themselves? If so, say, we do.
We do. Right.
Will you raise Colin in the church, surrounding him with the multitude of gifts bestowed by a community of faith, that by your teaching and example, as well as ours, he may be guided to accept God's grace for himself, profess his faith openly, and lead a Christian life? If so, say, we will.
We will.
Right. Thank you. Amen. And now for our congregation, we have promises to make to you as well. So do you, as Christ's body, the church, reaffirm your faith and commitment to Christ? Do you embrace and support this family as they raise Colin? If so, say, we do.
We do.
Amen. I love the energy. Will you nurture one another in the Christian faith and extend your care and guidance for Colin as he grows in faith? If so, say, we will with God's help.
We will with God's help.
Amen. Amen. Let us go to God in prayer. Eternal God, your mighty acts of salvation have been made known through water. From the moving of your Spirit upon the waters of creation, to the deliverance of your people through the flood and through the Red Sea. In the fullness of time, you sent Jesus, nurtured in the water of a womb, baptized by John and anointed by your Spirit. He called his disciples to share in the baptism of his death and resurrection. Pour out your Holy Spirit to bless this gift of water and he who will receive it, and clothe him in righteousness throughout his life. Amen. Amen. I'm going to invite you all to step on a bit closer, and I'll take him if that's good with you. Hi, Colin. Hello.
He's such a cutie.
You're welcome. Colin Ritchie, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Oh, it's nice and lukewarm. Thank you, Beth. And he's just like, ooh, that feels good. I'm going to invite you to put your hand on his leg, arm, shoulder, wherever you can reach. And I'm going to invite everyone to reach out your hand in blessing. Colin, may the Holy Spirit work within you that being born through water and the Spirit, you may remain a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
There are words for us to officially welcome our new sibling in Christ, and they are going to be on the screen for us. As we're saying them, if it's okay, I'm going to walk around so that they can see him up close, because he's too cute and I don't want to give him back yet. So, family of God, we commend Colin to your love and care. Will you live in such a way that he may grow in the knowledge and love of God through Jesus Christ? And let us respond together. No, he's so cute. I'm gonna come this way a little bit. He's still solidly sleeping here. I'll come around there too. Say hi. Did you all get to see him? No? Say hi, so cute. We have a little kids section here with some kids' toys, and we're getting it some action today. Here we are. Say hello. Come on, say hi. Come on, say hi, brother. Nice job. You're welcome. I'm coming back, I promise. I'll give him back to you. Can you tell I like doing baptisms? They are a joy. So I will give him back to you. I promised. Ooh, it's okay. He's like, no. Cute. And here we have a baptism certificate. I'll give that to you. All right. Thank you. Congratulations. And let's celebrate with our new sibling. Thank you. Before I pass it off to Faith for children's time, I will leave this baptismal water open. You caught the words when I said we are given the opportunity to remember our own baptisms. We are welcome at the end of the service to come forward and touch the waters and use them as a sign to mark a cross on your forehead or on your hand. Sprinkle yourself, do whatever, to remember that you are a beloved child of God, blessed, called, loved for who you are. Amen? Amen. I'll pass it on now.
Good morning. I am Faith Evers. I am the Children's Ministry Coordinator here, which means that the baby falls under my jurisdiction from now on. Today in Sunday school, we're going to be talking about squeezing things in to make them fit. Or when Noah squeezed all the animals into the ark. It was a lot of them. Two of every kind of animal he had to put into one boat. Do you think we could fit every animal into one boat? No. It would be tricky. So, how many we can squeeze into this hula hoop? How many? Not many. You go ahead, Emma. We have one. Go ahead. Two. Three. Four. You want to squeeze in, Dylan? Can you fit? Oh, he's got little feet. He can fit. Oh. Oh, we got one more. Oh, he's coming. Get a picture of that, Beth. Okay, and now I'm going to take all the kids and we can go downstairs for Sunday school.
This song this morning, We Are All the Stars. It's just very fitting for a Sunday with a baptism and as we start this Encanto series, because it's saying we are all the stars in one sky. We are all part of one family. Everybody unique with their own gifts, but we are all one. So please enjoy.
In the binders that were passed around during our announcements, you will find prayer cards. As you have any prayers that you need to share within the community of faith and trust that others are praying with you, celebrating with you or lifting you up when you're going through some hard times. Please do utilize those prayer cards, which you can place into the offering plate as that passes later in the service. Know that you can also call the main office. Sandy will be back in the office tomorrow, or you can email office@sentforothers.org, and she will include your prayers within the prayer email that goes out every Monday morning, or Monday noonish. We will have an opportunity to, we're about to shift into prayer, so I invite you to think of there, if there are any names of individuals, circumstances that you would like to lift. We'll do an all together lifting our voices to pray towards the end of our prayer. So I invite you to join your heart and spirit with mine. Good and gracious God, our hearts are full of gratitude this morning for your generous, unconditional love. We thank you especially today for your church and our new brother in Christ, Colin Ritchie. Our church family is a gift to us as individuals, as families, and to our entire community. We pray, dear God, for our church in the days, months, and years ahead. Renew us in spirit and in ministry as we move forward in faith, continuing to grow with you and with one another. We lift to you prayers now for those who are battling devastating diseases and illness like cancer and dementia, depression and addictions. Pour your healing spirit into our lives, hearts, bodies, and relationships that all may experience your healing and wholeness. We hold in focused prayer one of our longtime members today, Eleanor, as she is recovering from a fall and the doctors and nurses are just discovering how to care for her best. Be her peace and her strength as she recovers. We pray for physicians and medical teams that they might be agents of your healing for Eleanor and anyone in distress, and for caregivers who are pouring themselves out in love for their family and friends. Give strength and healing of heart to those who are grieving this day, and help us to embrace and celebrate life for the gift it is. Grant each one of us patience, hope, and trust in your unfailing love, and renew us in heart and spirit. We offer now our prayers, anything that is on our hearts that we need to lift to you aloud, and we raise our voices together to bring you our prayers. We offer you our prayers, O God, the ones spoken aloud and from the silence of our hearts, trusting that you hear and you respond in powerful ways, whether we see our desired outcome or not. Help us to trust that you are with us and will see us through. Amen. Amen. And now we lift our voices to pray the prayer that Jesus taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Our scripture reading this morning comes from the book of Ephesians, chapter 4, verses 11 through 16. He himself granted that some are apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, and teachers to equip the saints for the work of ministry, for building up the body of Christ until all of us come to the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God, to maturity, to the measure of the full stature of Christ. We must no longer be children, tossed to and fro and blown about by every wind of doctrine, by people's trickery, by their craftiness and deceitful scheming. But speaking the truth in love, we must grow up in every way into him who is the head, into Christ, from whom the whole body, joined and knit together by every ligament with which it is equipped, as each part is working properly, promotes the body's growth in building itself up in love. This is the word of God for the people of God.
I've been waiting for this Encanto sermon series, so I'm super excited. So I love a good story. Whether reading a book, watching a movie or a TV show, stories have a way of helping us reflect on morals and life lessons. We relate to the characters and imagine how we would feel in their shoes. Our scriptures are full of storytelling. And before they were even written down, stories of creation, the flood, Abraham and Sarah, Moses and King David were shared generation after generation to capture the heart of our faith and our belief in God and pass along lessons about who God is calling us to be. Jesus followed in this tradition, and often in response to questions he was asked, he would respond by storytelling. In parable form, often. The Good Samaritan, the prodigal son, a shepherd seeking out the lost sheep, a man who built his house upon the rock. Stories have a way of capturing our imaginations and speaking to the heart. This is as true today as it was in Jesus' day. Only today, we have the gift of technology, enabling us to capture our creative storytelling in film of all types and genres, like Disney films. Some think that kids' movies are just for kids, but really, they're not. Speaking as a mom who's watched a few Disney films recently, they're packed with lessons about life and relationships, values and morals. Life lessons that are applicable for all ages. And often we can't fully appreciate all the lessons packed into them until we watch them with the eyes of experience and a heart that has lived through the ups and downs of life. Have you ever gone back and watched a video or a film, a movie that you watched as a kid, and go, oh, I didn't realize that was a subplot line. Interesting. Disney's new hit, Encanto, is no different. In fact, it has quickly become one of my favorites. Over the next few weeks, we'll be unpacking some of the lessons found within this treasure of a film. And while you don't have to have seen the movie in order to experience and appreciate the messages within, it couldn't hurt. And I know that you would be blessed by the experience. So, we hope to have you join us after church today in the social hall, where we'll have lunch prepared, some quesadillas and taquitos and some other delicious treats. And we'll watch Encanto together. Or we encourage you to find time at home or with a friend to watch on your own time. So as the story opens, we get to meet each member of the family Madrigal, a family that has been blessed with magical gifts to be used for the building up of a community. Some are gifts of healing, controlling the weather, talking with animals, superhuman strength, or incredible hearing abilities, shape-shifting to impersonate another, or the ability to grow flowers and plants with a tiny wave of a hand. Might want that for gardening skills. Gifts that are all granted during a coming of age ceremony where a doorway to a magical, or of their magical house, casita, appears and illumines, lights up, and welcomes them to their own special room, matching their own special gift. That is, except for Mirabelle. At her gift ceremony, she stood at the doorway, anxiously awaiting the blessing promised to each member of her family. She went to grab for the doorknob, and the door begins to disappear, and nothing special happens. She is the only one in her family to not receive a special gift. We're going to watch a quick scene where the kids from the town discover that Mirabelle is the only one without a gift. And I invite you to pay close attention to both how they and she deals with this news. Let's watch. I love that. You must be really sad. To which she responds, "Gift or no gift, I am just as special as the rest of my family." Brave words, but you can see from the expression on her face that she struggles with being ordinary. And so too does her family. They don't know how to treat her. They don't know what value she brings to the family and the community. How can she help other than stay out of the way as they all put their special gifts to use? Have you ever felt like you don't measure up compared to the amazing giftedness you see in others? I know I have. At times, I've wondered what I could possibly add to a situation, or how I could serve with my pretty ordinary gifts. I'm not particularly excellent at anything. I'm good at a few things, but not excellent. Not sports or music or strength. Could go on. I'm just ordinary. Wait, am I alone in my ordinariness? Okay, good. But here is where our thinking of special gifts has gone astray along the way. Whether we've been blessed with a super special gift or talent, one that makes us shine like a star, we all have unique gifts to offer for the building up of a community. In Paul's letter to the Ephesians, he talks about how each person has spiritual gifts that work together to build up the body of Christ. He writes of these gifts often to the early church communities. In his first letter to the Corinthians, he argues that no gift is more important or valuable than another. But then, interestingly, he goes on to say, strive for the greater gifts. Nothing is more valuable, nothing is better, but strive for the greater one. It's Paul. It's good. But then he shifts into what we know pretty familiarly from weddings, 1 Corinthians 13. If I speak in the tongues of mortals and of angels, but have not love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have all power and all strength so as to remove mountains, but do not have love, I gain nothing. He wraps up this lesson with faith, hope, and love abide, but the greatest of these is love. Love is a gift that is given to each one of us. It is the motivation that should undergird the use and application of all the other gifts and talents we possess. For if we do not have love, we miss the point. We make our giftedness all about ourselves rather than for the building up of others and the community as a whole. As the storyline of Encanto unfolds, we watch as Mirabel uses her ordinary gift of love to help her family members, supporting her younger cousin as he prepares very nervously for his gift ceremony. She encourages her sister to embrace her full scope of gifts, not just the beautiful ones. We'll talk about that next week. She embraces her uncle Bruno, when no one else in the family will even talk about him, and doing everything she can, she tries so hard to save her family's magic. A song that she sings earlier on in the movie, Waiting on a Miracle, comes to fruition when she and the family realize that it's not the special gifts that define a person's value, but rather working together, bringing the ordinary and extraordinary together to serve in love that saves the day and is the true miracle. We, you and I, each one of us is gifted not only with talents to share that make us shine, but with spiritual gifts to be used for building up the body of Christ in love. We are all vitally important and have a role to play. As the family Madrigal learns, it is only when we all bring our gifts together in a spirit of love that amazing work can be accomplished. A house rebuilt, a community shaped, neighbors serving neighbors. I wonder what gifts we have to offer that can help us work together to serve the community here in Clinton. How has God equipped us to do our part to build up the body of Christ in love? This week, as we engage with others, let us celebrate one another's giftedness and put our gifts to use, doing God's work to share faith, hope, and love, remembering that the greatest of these is love. Amen. Amen. I invite us to respond through this song of reception of gifts and using gifts, a song that often goes with confirmation, which is a blessing of the Holy Spirit and a celebration of membership. So let us sing together, Holy Spirit, come confirm us, number 331. Let us rise and sing if we're able. You may be seated.
Thanksgiving for the diversity of gifts that you have given us. We pray, Lord, that we might use them in unison with one another to the full measure of Christ to build up your kingdom here on earth. In his name we pray. Amen.
We ask, as you're able, to remain standing to join us in praise and worship with Come What May.
Sometimes heartache is the gift I need. Your faithful in all things. In every high, in every low, on mountain tops, down broken roads, you're still my rock, my hope. Thank you.
down in green pastures. The Lord is my shepherd, leads me to still waters, and he restores my soul. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. The Lord is my shepherd, leads me to still waters, and he restores my soul. In every high, in every low, on mountain tops, down broken roads, you're still my rock, my hope remains. I'll rest in the arms of Jesus. In every high, in every low, on mountain tops, down broken roads, you're still my rock, my hope remains. I'll rest in the arms of Jesus. Come what may, come what may, come what may, come what may.
We truly do rest in the arms of Jesus. No matter the trials and struggles, no matter those times that we feel like we don't measure up, we are truly blessed with gifts, blessed with the gift of God's love in our hearts and meant to be lived out in our lives. One of the gifts that our congregation has been gifted with and blessed to share with is, he doesn't know I'm doing this, but the Richards are gonna be moving. Ryan Richards and Kathy.
Kathy couldn't be here today.
Right, Kathy, who couldn't be here today, but they're gonna be moving. And today is their last Sunday with us. Yeah. So I just wanted to make sure that we took an opportunity to thank you for sharing your gifts with us and to trust, or we're gonna bless you. And trust that we're going to miss you.
Thank you.
And that God will go with you and guide you and bless you to be a blessing wherever you go. So come on out here a little bit. You don't have to. It's okay. It's okay. I know you have music. Okay. Music to be played. Okay. Thank you. Thank you. You're welcome. Let us reach out our arms. God, we give you thanks for Ryan and Kathy, for the blessings you have made in them, the joy and love that they share with each other and with us as a community of faith and with others, everyone they experience. We ask you to continue to pour your blessings out upon them as they move and transition to a new home and a new community. May their gifts continue to bless others and each other and you. In your holy name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Thank you, Pastor Jess.
You're welcome. God bless you. And as we go from this place, may we go filled with the Holy Spirit's presence, trusting that our gifts are shared, that they're enough, and when they are used with God's love, they will do amazing things to bring hope, to rebuild communities, and to do God's kingdom work everywhere we go. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen.